Hello, this is Sheshachalam from Astro Guide Mysore. So today we are discussing Sasa Yoga. Sasa Yoga is a yoga of the highest caliber and of the most importance. Of all the yogas of the Panchamahapurusha Yoga, we have seen Ruchaka Yoga of Mars, Bhadra Yoga of Mercury, Hamsa Yoga of Jupiter. Yesterday we saw Malavya Yoga of Venus. And today we are seeing one of the most strongest of the Panchamahapurusha Yoga. Not one of the, it is the strongest Panchamahapurusha Yoga. That is Sasa Yoga. And how does Sasa Yoga happen? It happens if Saturn is placed in the Kendra and if it is exalted or in its own sign. So there are two conditions. Though Saturn is in own sign or in exaltation position, if it is not in the Kendra from the ascendant, then there is no Sasa Yoga. So it should be in Kendra from the ascendant, and this Kendra should be seen in the Bhava Kundali. So please be clear, it should be in the Bhava Kundali. I have discussed this arc and all these things in my earlier classes. Please refer my earlier classes, understand the Bhava chart, understand many other yogas of the first few yogas. Sunapa Yoga and Anapa Yoga, I have discussed how actually it forms or it doesn't form at all because of the degree placements of the planet. So if Saturn is placed in the Rashi Kundali in the 4th house and in the own sign, but if it is placed in the 5th house in the Bhava chart, that means there is no Sasa Yoga. For example, let us see now for all what all ascendants Sasa Yoga is applicable. So Saturn is play, if it is the one house of Saturn is Aquarius and Capricorn, and its exaltation position is in the sign of Libra at 20 degrees. So we can see that this ascendant will get Sasa Yoga, that is because of the 7th and the 10th positions, if at all it falls there. So there is a chance. So this will get Sasa Yoga. This is Vrishabha, that is Taurus, because of this 10th position. Here you do not get Sasa Yoga because the 5th, in the 8th and the 9th, so you do not get Sasa Yoga. Next, here you get it in Cancer because it is the 7th and the 4th. You get it for Leo because it is the 7th. Here you do not get it because it is the 4th. You know, there is no Sasa Yoga because Saturn is not in the Kendra here. Here anyway it is placed in the ascendant itself, and the 4th house also is applicable. Here it is applicable because it is the 4th house, and once again here it is not applicable because there are no planets in the Kendras. So here, that is for Capricorn, it is applicable because the Lagnadipati itself is Saturn, and in the Lagna or the 10th house a very powerful Sasa Yoga happens. So here also it happens because of this. And here once again it doesn't happen. So you can see that for Hamsa Yoga and Sasa Yoga, the four corners, for Sasa Yoga and one more yoga, I think it is Ruchaka Yoga, the four corners are left off. They do not have the pleasure of having this yoga. So these ascendants do not get Sasa Yoga at all. Though in this for Virgo ascendant and for Gemini ascendant, Jupiter is the 5th lord for Virgo and 9th lord for Gemini. Still, Sasa Yoga does not happen for these ascendants. So, what I was talking earlier is, for example, if this is the ascendant, and let us say the ascendant is at 10 degrees. So, if the ascendant is at 10 degrees and Saturn in the 4th house, 1, 2, 3, 4, is at 28 degrees, there is no Sasa Yoga. Why? Because the midpoint of the first house is 10 degrees, second house is again 10 degrees, third house is 10 degrees, the midpoint I'm telling, fourth house midpoint is 10 degrees, that means from here you have to take 15 degrees, that is 25 degrees. So 10 plus 15 is 25. So what happens? After 25, Saturn is placed, so there is no Sasa Yoga. Maybe a partial yoga will arise, but still it is partial, it is not total. So okay, that I will not once again keep explaining the degrees. You people have to refer my earlier videos if you have to understand the Bhava and its relevance. Okay, so Sasa Yoga is one of the powerful yoga because it gives the most toughest attitudes of a human for a human being. You cannot buy those attitudes. You need to sit and do a lot of meditation to get those attitudes, and you get that attitude by birth if you have Sasa Yoga, and they are you start gaining experience. That is, people will not just do it for money. They will learn. They will learn everything by heart, and they will have the knowledge of how to implement it. So implementation, the knowledge of implementation. This knowledge is not theoretical knowledge. It is not practical knowledge. It is experience because of practice. So there is difference. So if you know theory, Jupiter, and if you know practical knowledge and skill, that is Venus, here it is daily routine or practice. That is the way of life. That is Saturn. Saturn is a way of life. That is why we fall to the feet of elderly people. We don't shake hands with them, or we don't, you know, just do like this to them. We fall to their feet. And in some communities, even Pada Puja, that is the feet will be washed, cleaned, and even it will be worshipped. The relevance, it is just a significance. It's not that anybody's feet has to be worshipped, or it has to be, you know, pedicure has to be done, you know, by inviting some people to the house. You are doing pedicure to some old man sitting in the chair. Nonsense. It's not like that. If anybody who doesn't know the customs and traditions of Vedic culture, they feel that somebody is unnecessarily doing some nonsense. But it goes to a higher level of nonsense when the, you know, the water is given as a prasad for somebody. That is nonsense. But you should understand why this started. Why old people, people with high experience and knowledge, were summoned, and their Pada Puja, that is their feet was worshipped, was only because to acknowledge the experience this person has, where all this person might have gone on his legs. Earlier days, people would walk the distance to get the experience. They would not get experience wherever they sit. Nobody will come and teach you where you are. Today, we are getting online teaching. We are getting everything to our, you know, in our hand. If you have this one instrument and hold it, you can start, getting knowledge. But how is that knowledge worth or equivalent to the knowledge a person would gain going to a guru, searching him wherever he is, going to each and every guru to attain lot of multiple faculties? So this is stronger because when, for example, if I would want to learn sericulture, sericulture is to grow, cocoons like silkworms. Anyway, I despise people rearing or wearing silk itself because I have a different way of thinking. But if at all I want to know how to do, let me give another example. If at all I want to know how to grow coconuts and coconut trees, what would I do? I will go to a place where people are growing coconuts. I will see that I know somebody. I'll stay in their house for a month or 2 months or 3 months in the season when they actually can teach me. They are free and teach me, and or they are working. Join with them and work. This is because you cannot learn what the Saturn has learned from books. You cannot learn. It is impossible. It's impossible to learn anything what Saturn has learned using books or by reading or by listening. You cannot do that. You have to act. That is, you have to get involved in the karma. That is why Saturn is called the karma adhipati, karma adhipati, or he is the karaka for karma. The onus or the responsibility a person would lift and go and perform is his duties is Saturn. So that is why there is no competition here. Why? This is not a knowledge which is you know, which just comes by 1 or 2 years of experience. It's a lifetime. These people would have put their lifetime in any one sector. They would be masters. It is not jack of all, it's a master of one subject, and they would be top level masters. So they will not easily teach anybody. They are very strict. A benefic Saturn, this is the whole thing. Benefic Saturn, they also have a very good attitude of tolerance. They can tolerate all nonsense going around them, but they will do their work. These people do not unnecessarily get distracted. So, okay, tolerance. I have put double N. It becomes tolerance. Okay, fine. So, if this Sasa Yoga gets a combination of a malefic, I have given you the details here. If Saturn goes along with Rahu and is very close to Rahu and becomes a malefic within the Sasa Yoga, the gains, the way a person would earn his money would be sometimes unethical. I am not telling always, because it also depends on many factors, like if you have Jupiter or if you have a righteous planet, like a strong moon, like a, you know, a Paurnami moon sitting in the ascendant, then it would not happen. So, but that's what it is, like thumb rules have to be accepted but also verified. You should not simply take thumb rules just like that. These are thumb rules, but you have to verify them. So, unscrupulous means of gains when Saturn and Rahu is placed in the Sasa Yoga position, that is in the Kendra from ascendant. So, if you have Saturn, Moon and Ketu, this is a difficult, you know, because Moon and Ketu itself will put a person into a difficult mental state, but Saturn, Moon and Ketu will make a person melancholic and easy, you know, they are prone to depression. Until unless once again the Lagnadipati is strong and it is well placed, they become depressive, disturbed, and also sometimes if the Lagnadipati is also negatively strong, they become secretive and have hidden agendas. So they start doing all activities which are not socially ethical once again. So if Jupiter or Moon or Sun are malefic, or malefic in a chart, any one of them, that is why I think I had put is. So either one of them is malefic. So if Jupiter or Moon or Sun, either one of them is malefic in a chart with Sasa Yoga happening, then the person may think evil and be wicked. This is a very important point. That is, when Jupiter, that is wisdom, when the luminaries, consciousness, you know, what is Moon? Emotional and ethical consciousness. What is Jupiter? Wisdom. If you don't have Viveka, you are called as an Aviveki. That is what a Sanskrit word which is opposite to Viveka. Aviveki means a fool. So, Viveki means a guy with wisdom. So, people who though have Sasa Yoga may lose the credibility of the Sasa Yoga, which is actually good experience. They will have pessimistic experience. Sun is also known for its consciousness. So conscience, the soul, the Atma Bala. So if these planets are weak, then Sasa Yoga will once again not manifest positively. It will go into a negative way. So once again, let me go into the ascendants. You will understand. If the ascendant is in such and such a place, then what might happen? Where might the person go? What he will achieve in his life? So all these things, let us go through and see. So if the ascendant is, for example, if it is Karkataka Rashi, if the ascendant is here and you have Saturn in the 7th house, this person may have go through a delayed marriage, because Saturn is a slow moving planet. The marriage might be delayed because of so many achievements or responsibilities which the person will have to execute in his early part of life. So that means he will be endowed with lot of responsibilities even when he is within his 20s. So secondly, if it is in the fourth house, this person will go into top level management. He will get into a very good job simply because Saturn is exalted in the fourth house. This is a very good placement, and this creates a very strong Raja Yoga. Though Saturn is the seventh and the eighth lord for Cancer, though it is the eighth lord, it gives lot of ayu and it gives a good lifestyle for the person. So this particular Saturn is one of the strongest Saturn. This is called as a happy Saturn because it is the Mula Trikona, and many people ask that if the ascendant is Leo, then is there Sasa Yoga? Because Sasa Yoga happens with Saturn, and Saturn is a malefic for Leo, and it is actually a very strong malefic. It is a Maraka Adipati. Maraka, people are asking me, what is Maraka? Marakas are the second and the seventh lords which actually cause harm to a person's longevity and may cause harm like accidents, fatalities. So we'll talk about Marakas, Drakkanas, Karadrakkanas and all those things later. So when we talk about the longevity, I'll come and talk about that particular point where the Mrityu Amsha, the Karadrakkanas are to be referred. So Maraka also, I will refer it there itself, not here. So here, though it is a prime malefic for Leo Lagna, this particular position softens the character of Saturn. It is the most beautiful place of Saturn because it is the Mula Trikona. You should see whether it is really posited in the Mula Trikona degree or not, or else it will be a normal own house Saturn. But if it's not own sign and it's Mula Trikona, this is a fantastic position. These people will be very strong businessmen and politicians. So anyway, this particular ascendant, for this particular ascendant, it is a Raja Yoga. When it is in the 10th house, it becomes a Raja Yoga. Alone Saturn itself can make a person extremely rich, very eminent, like a scholar, like a highly knowledgeable person, socially known. People will know him in his community and also across the world sometimes, depending on where Venus is posited and Sun is posited. But this is a very, very strong yoga. So there are, once again, there is another yoga which actually we should understand. This particular yoga, when the ascendant is in the sign of Aries and Saturn is in the 7th house, exalted. So people have this mythical knowledge or confused knowledge that because Saturn gets debilitated in Aries, this is what they ask me, because Saturn gets debilitated in Aries, so for Aries Lagna, when Saturn is exalted also, then it will be malefic. This is how, they have, I don't know from where they get this beautiful knowledge and phrases, they make this. Because Saturn gets debilitated in Aries, that means for Aries, Saturn is a prime malefic always. Who told it's going to be like that? It's not going to be like that. So if Saturn is in the 7th house and exalted, these people are extraordinary businessmen. Only thing is, if it has a slight malefic disposition also, then the yoga will become very frail and it will be negatively strong. So when it is the Lagnadipati itself, for example, in this ascendant, and it is in the 10th house, because it is the Lagnadipati, though there is little bit of malefic, if it is here for Capricorn Lagna, this is the 10th. So though there is a malefic disposition of Rahu or some planet along with Saturn, the yoga will not become negative. It will be more a little positive itself, because it is the Lagnadipati, it is the ascendant lord. So like, for example, if this is the ascendant and we have a weak moon here, a weak moon in the sense that we have these planets here. I have told you it's a tough position. But still for this ascendant, it will not let go the native. It will hold the native. It will support the native because it is the Lagnadipati. So one should understand when you are delineating the chart whether it is the Lagnadipati, what it is to the ascendant. What are the lordships that particular planet holds? Where is it posited from those places? Like for example, for Aries, if Saturn is in the 7th, that means it is in the 9th from the Mula Trikona, 10th from Capricorn, 9th from Aquarius and 10th from Capricorn. So Saturn has moved positively there for Aries. Beautiful position. You know, the 9th and the 10th Lord exalted in the 7th house. What else a person requires? It's one of the strongest Sasa Yogas present. So I think I have covered a lot here today. So Sasa Yoga is one of the strong, one of the, not one of the, I keep telling that it is the strongest of the Panchamahapurusha Yogas. As the Saturn is the slowest moving planet, the effect of Sasa Yoga will be long standing and throughout life. So once a person becomes a prodigy or something, like for example, I'll give you an example of A.R. Rahman. So he became a child prodigy in music. Maybe he is not having Sasa Yoga. I'm just giving an example that the effect of that particular thing what he achieved will be there throughout his life. Like Sachin Tendulkar is going to have throughout his life he is famous. You cannot take away the fame from him because people have given so much of love and respect. So the same way Sasa Yoga people will make a name forever, permanent. For many years it will be there even after their death, even after 2 generations, even after 20 generations. Sasa Yoga is one of the yogas which will give you such a long standing identity in the society. So thank you very much for today's class.